Hello everyone, thanks for joining us today. My name is Charles Rice. I'm the host for today's webinar, Simcenter SCADAS XS, Everything You Need to Know. Your presenter for today is Aneska. Aneska, would you like to introduce yourself?
Yeah, good morning everyone. My name is Agnieszka Utarzewska and I'm a product manager in our acoustic testing group. I'm speaking to you today from Belgium. So it's about 7 p.m. But I'm very happy to host this presentation for you.
Thank you, Aneska. Thanks for joining us this evening for you, this morning for us on the West Coast, maybe. Well, with that, I think we can turn it over to Aneska and get started.
There was a very interesting visual study, an experiment conducted by the Harvard Innovation Lab. It's called The Evolution of a Desk. And it's actually a photographic transition showing first the desk as it looked like in the 1980s. And you can see it's fairly busy. Next to the desktop PC, we do have fax machines, quite a lot of documents, a phone, a calculator, and many, many others. And it finishes around 2015, 2020, with this picture, where every single item which is there on that desk, it's actually something that we carry with us on a daily basis in our pockets, either a smartphone or a laptop PC. They serve the same purpose and they have the same functionality. I invite you to take a look at the video. It's very entertaining, but it shows very nicely how we went from fax machines to, being reachable everywhere in the world with our smartphones in our pockets. And a very similar transition happened in the world of data acquisition. Here is a picture from about 1985. On the desk, you see a SCADAS 2 system with a desk PC. And you can imagine there is not that much space left on the desk because although a fantastic acquisition system for its time, it was rather bulky. You can see by the size of the keyboard, these likely stayed the same size. It was not the tiniest of the solutions. Now, if we fast forward to today, if you take a deeper and closer look into the picture, on the bottom right-hand side, you can see a small acquisition hardware, and that is actually the star of our presentation today, the SCADAS XS. So we will talk about a few things today. First of all, the SCADAS XS and what is in the box, but also how you can connect to your XS, what kind of apps are available to make your life easier and make you more efficient in the field. Why is it an open system? And finally, we'll finish with a coffee break, but you will see more about it at the end of this presentation. So let's start with what's in the box. But before we take a deeper dive, let's just take a look at some numbers. SCADAS XS has about 6 hours of battery autonomy. This actually means a full operational day of testing. It's really lightweight at 540 grams, or let's say plus minus 1 pound. It's one of the smallest systems available on the market. It fits in your pocket and you can take it anywhere you want. It supports, how we call it, 12 plus channels, and I will explain that in a detail. And it is a very open system. You can export the data measured by a SCADAS XS to over 16 different formats. And you don't need to pay any license for that. This tool comes for free with the SCADAS XS. So about the channels. I mentioned the 12 plus, and that's, that's not a, let's say, a marketing term. It's really more than 12 channels. The system comes in a 6 or 12 channel version, and that's 12 analog or ICP channels with TET support. So you have four times three connections at the side with breakout cables. You can connect either microphones, accelerometers. We'll discuss this more in a second. Next to that, there is a input for a Simcenter SCADAS 3D binaural headset to measure binaural data. So I have here a binaural headset such as this. We're going to use it in a moment. I'm going to show you how it works. There's also an SPDIF digital audio input connection, which allows you to connect, for an example, a binaural head, a GPS connection, a CAN connector to connect your digital control area network and measure sensors from the bus of the vehicle. There are two analog tachometer inputs, and finally, You can also measure the video stream from the tablet, which comes with the SCADAS XS, to have synchronized video alongside your SCADAS XS measurement. So what do the 12 plus channels mean in practice? Let's take a look at the first setup. We start with all the sensors that I mentioned. We have the headset, we have binaural head, two analog tachometers, Canvas GPS and camera. That's going to be our baseline. In all three of these setups, that's what we're going to be measuring always. But on top of this, you can connect 12 ICP microphones. So I would say that's a fairly nice system. For example, for sound power measurement, you can already measure quite a lot. A very similar setup, but rather than acoustics, let's focus on vibration data. We do same basic analysis, well, not so basic. Again, headset, binaural head, two tacos, GPS, scan, and video stream. And on top of it, we can connect 12 accelerometers, single-axis accelerometers. Or if you want to go for a bit of a mixed mode, we can, for an example, again, start from the same baseline, but connect 6 microphones and 2 triax accelerometers. And again, that's all in this very small 1 pound or half a kilo weight of a SCADAS measurement system. So we prepared for you an interesting exercise. We wanted to check which of these is more exciting, ski or snowboard. And of course, that was just one of the reasons to go check. Actually, what you want to test during the evaluation process of designing a snowboard or skis is what kind of loads this equipment undergoes in real conditions. So you need realistic boundary conditions during an operational test, and that's actually what we did, an operational model analysis as input for your simulation models to have decent, good quality, well-correlated simulation. So our colleagues were kind enough to take a SCADAS XS with them on the slopes and test both their skis and then snowboards in real time with some additional video information and GPS location for position and speed at the same time. And you can see they were not very bothered. It fit in the backpack. They could measure without any problems and enjoy their ski holidays. So to summarize, a SCADAS XS, it's a personal acquisition system. It's handheld, it fits in your pocket, and you can measure real life circumstances without any issues or impact on your measurement quality. It behaves just like the big box, but definitely is a much more suitable solution for anywhere you need to be flexible. So let's talk about how you can connect to the XS and what type of measurement setups you can perform with the such a small solution. So there are three modes in which you can use the SCADAS XS. The first one is the standalone mode. And the scenario here is fairly simple. Imagine there's a factory in which you're producing your equipment and there is an acoustic issue. So what you can do is you can load your measurement template, for an example, a number of microphones and accelerometers, put the system in a box, ship it to the other side of the world, and ask the person located there to put on the headphones. These are actually not regular headphones. This is a measurement headset, which means it has, next to being a normal headphone, also a left and a right microphone, which collects the data in a very similar way as a binaural head. It measures the sound as if you were there and gives a very nice stereo feeling. And the operator has to put the system on, the light becomes red, and the moment you are ready, just, you know, press the button. So we are now recording. I take my sound source. Stop the measurement and you can check if everything is okay by pressing the replay button. So we are now recording. I take my sound source. And it's there. The quality was okay. I heard the noise that I want to report to the NVH engineer on the other side of the world. I'm ready. I turn the XS off, ship it back. The measurement data is there, stored in an SD card, and you can start your analysis. Very simple. So the second mode of operation is where you take your SCADAS XS and you connect it to a laptop or a PC with TestLab or Test Express. This way it behaves just like any other frontend in the SCADAS family, and you can benefit from a very wide portfolio of different analysis solutions, from model analysis, impact testing, sound intensity, sound power, you name it. All of those you can use with a SCADAS XS, just with any other frontend from the SCADAS family. The final mode is a kind of a mix in between the two, where we have the SCADAS XS in the field, but we can also benefit from having a tablet application such as this one. This way, you can actually do your acquisition setup. You can monitor your data during the measurement. You can replay to the data. You can filter the data. We will go a bit more in depth on the functionalities of the app in a moment. But in general, you have an insight into what is being measured still directly on the field, meaning that you can validate your measurement before you go back to the office, and there's a much smaller chance that you have to repeat the run. Now, the big question is, because we said 12 plus channels, quite a lot, what if you need more? So there is a very interesting solution possible. What you can do is you can connect more than one XS in a master-master configuration by means of a switch and go to a multi-frontend solution where all the SCADASes will be measuring in a synchronized way into one LDSF file. So you can connect up to 7 of these devices together via a switch and really build quite a significant setup in case you just need to. So if 12 is not enough, can happen, then connecting them together in the master-master mode is definitely an option as well. So a very nice case that we brought for you is taking your XS up into the clouds. We actually were able to successfully conduct measurement campaigns with both regular aircrafts as well as innovative electric aircrafts, where the XS was placed inside of the either a helicopter or an airplane and was measuring the NVH performance of these machines in real conditions. When flying, you can see on the screen, it was a fairly exciting measurement. Now, what made the XS very suitable for this is the fact that it's not only very small and lightweight, but it also has very good environmental specifications. Temperature range, the EMC, the vibration and shock, it's compliant with the MIL STD 810F standard. All of that was the kind of deciding factor why XS was a better solution than alternative options, even including from the SCADAS family. So I hope that you see that it's a very flexible system. You can measure in standalone mode, you can use it as a regular acquisition system in front-end mode, or you can benefit from the tablet application to have the flexibility of a standalone system, but with more insight into what is happening with the measurement. And this actually takes us into the third topic, which is discovering the apps that are accessible with your SCADAS XS. Let's start with Simcenter TestLab Scope. So in preparation for our measurement that we're going to do later, let's instrument the system. And keep in mind that this is something that you will be able to do without the need of a PC, meaning that you have the SCADAS XS, you will have the tablet, and that's enough to completely instrument your measurement setup. So we're doing it really from scratch, meaning that the sensors are connected. We have a headset, Tri-X, and a microphone, and I'm starting by instrumenting and filling in the information for the Tri-X. So I'm giving some names to my channels. You can see that it's already set as a vibration channel. I have to choose direction and set the sensitivity, because this accelerometer it's not a TETS sensor. You can see that also in real time, I can visualize the levels of the sensor, which means I can also check if everything is okay, if I can tap on the sensor. All of that is available in real time during the acquisition. The nice thing here is you can copy paste information from one sensor to another, which makes it very easy, for an example for a Tri-X, to copy the information that is the same between all three sensors. So we fill in the third axis, the Z direction, and that is ready. We're going to enable the headset. Yeah, that was a very simple click. And finally work with the microphone, that's the fourth channel on our system, the 2A. So it's enabled. We're going to switch it from vibration to an acoustic channel and give it a name. This time it's going to be a microphone. The quantity is not acceleration this time, it's of course pressure. And rather than typing in the sensitivity manually, we're going to use the read test operation to pick up the sensitivity from the sensor itself. And you can also of course do it on the tablet. You can see that we're seeing some good levels on the system. So everything is instrumented. You can see that there are some other options. You can measure the taco, the GPS, the can, pick up the database from the tablet. You can trigger your measurement if you want to, or record the video. We're gonna do it right now. So see, we have the rear camera of the tablet and we can see that it's working. It works in real time. We can now save our template and store it on the XS itself and reuse it once the measurement is done. We can start our acquisition immediately. The second application that is available with the SCADAS XS is the Simcenter Tesla brand comparison. In our example, we are gonna try to compare a few runs measured with the XS while still being out of the office. So somewhere on the field, you want to make sure that your all the runs are okay, all the runs are according to the reference curves, and this is exactly what we're gonna try. So I have here an example, a few measured runs. I'm gonna compare four of them and looked into the analysis. So I immediately see the FFT spectra of these runs. I can decide to visualize also the reference curves on the screen and immediately see that two of them seem to be not so great. So I can check all the levels, maybe check different functions and try to see if perhaps some of the runs should be redone. So I'm now going to annotate the runs which don't comply with the reference curve, and while importing everything back into the desktop application, I will immediately see which runs I can pretty much skip because something was not okay. So it's nice, you don't have to worry about it on the track, just annotate it and your problem is over. It's also very interesting at the moment that you have a bit more complex measurement system. And for an example in here, we're also measuring a taco channel, and we want to make sure that also the analysis in function of the rotational speed is of high quality. So I have here two runs measured. You'll also see that actually they're not exactly the same profile. That's not a big problem. And the first benefit is the fact that you can already perform the audio replay and filtering still on in the field. So you can replay the data, you can apply some filters to make sure everything is okay. But you can also switch the function from FFT to quite a big selection, one of them being the order analysis. So see, now I'm comparing the data in function of orders, and I can move the cursor to check the level of each of the order, but also move the RPM range on which the calculation is being done. In here, the pink run has a slightly higher order content, around order 10.24. If you know our Simrod electric vehicle, then probably you know this is an issue coming from the gearbox. There's some gear wind present, and here the measurement showed us very well. And again, this is something that you learn still on the field without analyzing the data, without putting it into TestLab. You already get quite a lot of insight into the NVH behavior and performance of the, in this case, vehicle under test. And a good example of a customer that benefits from this kind of setup, from having the flexibility of a small system, as well as access to acquisition parameters and some analysis in the field, is Ducati. So they perform experimental model analysis on the track. And if you look into the picture at the bottom right, just behind the driver, the SCADAS XS is mounted on the bike, well, weighing less than 1 pound, about half a kilo. It's not affecting the performance of the vehicle that much, but it allows to measure all the loads acting on the bike in real time as input to FEM models to predict the performance of the bike and make sure that it's as fast as it can only be to be more performant on the track. So this concludes our section on the apps that you can use with your SCADAS XS. We talked about Simcenter Scope and Simcenter Tesla brand comparison. What I want you to take out of this is that Having an app like this that you can connect to your SCADA XS and validate the measurement pretty much anywhere you are without having to start up the PC and load the data and analyze it can be very beneficial. Gives you a lot of control over the quality of the data, gives you a lot of insight into what you're measuring even before any analysis has been done. So that's actually quite a lot of benefit and quite a lot of productivity increase because you minimize the amount of tests that you have to redo. Now, of course, not everyone has to use the TestLab application or Test Express. Of course, we would love that it is the case. But another strong point of the Simcenter XS solution for data acquisition is that it is a very open system. And what I mean by that is that if you have a SCADA XS, you can, of course, work with the TestLab and Test Express, but what you also get is a data recorder conversion tool. And this tool allows you to export your measured data into any of the formats which are now shown on the screen. So you can, for absolutely free, no license required, export your data into MATLAB, ASM ATFX, HDF, WAF, Excel, Universal Files, and many, many others. In order to further work with your data on any platform that you want. I would still suggest to look at TestLab. You know, you never know. It is a really fantastic tool. But what we wanted to make sure is that if you would like to stay maybe with your in-house procedures written in Excel or MATLAB, then it should be as easy as possible. And a great example of a customer that does just that is shown here on the slide. It's the Civil Protection Department in Italy. This department is responsible for monitoring the seismic behavior and how it affects buildings and bridges and other structures around Italy. So they work in this kind of preventive mode where they go into a building, instrument multiple SCADA XS's around the building. They have one tablet that they walk around the building to check, you know, if the sensors are okay, monitor the levels. And they do a kind of a operational model analysis in order to check how the building is behavior, if there are maybe any issues that should be taken care of prior to any potential seismic behavior. Now, this analysis that they do afterwards is done in MATLAB. But that is not a problem for them because, as I mentioned before, the SCADA XS comes with a free open tool to export your data. So the thing to remember is that investing in a SCADA XS means that you also get an access to quite a lot of external formats, which means you do not have to stick with the TestLab or Test Express environment. Of course you can. But you can also benefit from easily exporting your data to a number of external formats without a need for any additional license. So I've been talking for a while now, and I think it's definitely time for our coffee break. But rather than stepping away from the presentation, let's actually perform a very simple sound and vibration measurement. I'm going to show you how you can analyze it and benefit from combining traditional type of measurements such as microphone and acceleration data together with the visual aspect and recording the video as well. So what I have here is a small measurement setup. I have a microphone, a Tri-X accelerometer, I have my headset, we discussed it already, and everything is connected to this SCADA XS. I will be measuring with the help of scope application. So let me put on the headset. And on the scope, you'll see it later, I'm also having a feedback from my video camera from the tablet, which means next to the measuring of the sound and the vibration, I will be also recording the visual feedback of what is happening. And what's gonna happen is we're gonna have a very nice cup of coffee. So, let's see if everything is okay. I have the visual feedback from the tablet. I can see the levels measured at the microphones, at the accelerometer. Everything looks okay. Let's not hide the camera with our fingers. And voila, I'm gonna start measuring.
Thank you.
Okay, the data is measured. I already see it on the screen, which means I can replay the data to make sure that everything is captured in the highest quality possible. There are no clicks, no overloads, no close the door during the measurement. So let's quickly play. That sounds okay. So what we're going to do now is take indeed a very quick break. I'm going to enjoy my coffee. And I'm going to get the data back into the test-up application, do some analysis, and see what is the sound and vibration, the NVH performance of this espresso machine. Enjoy. Okay, so I'm going to now switch to my test-up application and share my screen also for the test-up so you'll be able to see everything together with me. So I have the SCADAS XS on my desk. It's connected via a USB cable to my PC, and I can already see it on the left side of the screen. And I can browse into my well, all the measurements that are stored on the SD card, which is inside of the SCADAS XS. And I will already tell you, I wish it was a bit cleaner, so apologies for that. And okay, so I have four measurements in total that were done in preparation, and well, by now I know that this is the one that we want to look on. That's the measurement that was done at the with the video. So let's import this. And as I do it, you see I also get the information about the run comment, meaning that I can also, after a measurement, annotate the run that I like. For an example, I'm sure that is really okay. So let's import that one. And it will appear in my test lab project structure just under the active section. If you're not familiar with test lab new application, that's the application you're seeing right now. It's the next generation of the test lab software, but it allows let's say compatibility between both platforms, meaning that you can work here and then go back to test lab classic or start with test lab classic, go back. Anything goes. Also means that data structure is very similar. So we have sections, runs, and then the actual measured data. So we of course also measured a video file, and that video was stored on the tablet. So I already copied it on my screen, and I'm going to import it into the measurement itself. So it's this one. And the nice thing is that it's actually saved with the same name as the measured run, so you don't really have to look that far to find it. And at the import, we get information such as the start of the measurement that's going to help us to check if it's synchronized. Okay, so let's take a look at our data. We have five measured time channels, which makes sense. We have three accelerometers, we have the binaural headset, and we have the signal from the ICP microphone. So I can focus just on the microphone and then add my video as well. Okay, and I'm gonna play it. You're probably not gonna be able to hear it, but I think you heard it enough already. So you can see that I can have the audio feedback, listen to the measured channels, either the acceleration or the acoustic channels, but I can also see how the measurement progresses on the screen, which can actually be very helpful, especially if there is some transient events that are occurring in the measurement, which may be well, something that you would like to investigate later on. Okay, so the data is on my screen, and I can do some small analysis. So I'm going to add it to the input basket, which is something we did in Test Lab Classic a lot. And now what is a little bit different in here is that rather than working through checkboxes and selections of what's going to be processed, we design our process graphically. I have designed the process up front. I will shortly explain it to you. It's a very simple way to look at it. Your data starts here at the input, and it can travel depending on how you design your process. So in here, I have a special method which allows me to say only measured channels with the name MIC go this way, and everything else stops. And then I have the same here, but in this case, if a channel,
the measured quantity is acceleration, then these channels pass through here. This allows me to specify different processing settings depending on things like channel name, measured quantity, but also run name and many others. So you have quite a lot of flexibility. And in this case, on the microphone, we do an average octave spectrum, a spectrum map. I also included some loudness calculation. And then we'll do just a spectrum average on the acceleration data. So the process is ready. Let's zoom that out a little bit. The data is in the input basket. So let's process the data. Run the process. And I get the progress indication at the bottom of my screen. Should be rather fast. This is not a long measurement. All right. So the data is now inside. You can see that my pivot view, that's the table that shows me all of the results, now is much bigger. And I see I have my, for an example, the spectrum calculation and the auto powers measured for the acceleration. I can add my octave spectrum, I can add my video and the loudness calculation as well. And as you can see, at the moment, the way I select items to appear on the screen, the displays just react automatically, which is a fairly nice improvement in efficiency. And I have my analysis. I see some interesting things happening on the screen. Let's maybe focus just on the auto power and zoom in a little bit. So there is quite some harmonics. We can check them with a harmonic cursor. Let's check. I have a feeling it might be something with 50 Hertz, which makes sense because most of the pumps, it's 50 Hertz. Most of the pumps in these espresso machines have work at 50 Hertz. But you can also let's say, okay, that's a short analysis. If you want to report that, you can already, I have something prepared for you up front. It's a simple combination of all this analysis that we just did. And what I can do is just click on the report button and generate it into either PowerPoint or a Word document. So it will appear automatically with a template that I designed up front, just an empty page in PowerPoint. Let's give it a moment to think about it. All right. Yeah, and you can see we have the information on the screen. That's the data measured with the SCADAS XS, but annotated also with the video. In this case, of course, this is not a video. This is the first frame of the video. So it's actually a static picture, but the rest of the slide is not. This is actually quite a neat feature from the Simcenter portfolio. It's called an active picture. So a report like this, if you send it to someone, they can actually get access to quite a lot of functionality still inside of PowerPoint or Word. So this is called an active picture, and it gives you the same functionality as we typically have in our desktop environment, which means you can not only do things like change colors, but you can also, for an example, add a double cursor and calculate a maybe an average value of the loudness of the trace. So you actually don't have to be a TestLab user. You don't have to have it installed on your PC in order to benefit from this kind of, in-depth view of the data and doing some more information, maybe some zooming in if you wanted to focus on a certain frequency rather than having to go back and forth into the software. It's quite an easy way to do it. Yeah, so yeah, see, this was still all in PowerPoint. And finally, we can also expand our replay capabilities and learn a little bit more. So again, I don't think you will be able to hear it, but with the video, we also see the instantaneous octave analysis, how the sound progresses with the with the coffee being poured into the espresso machine and so on. So it's quite a good view on the data that we have measured. Okay. So I'll bring you back to the presentation, which I'm afraid meanwhile closed for me. So sorry for that. I'll summarize it for you at the very end because we are almost over. Yeah. Okay. So this was a very short overview of what SCADAS XS is. It's a handheld personal acquisition system. I showed you a little bit of the different ways that you can work with the XS. So for an example, now I'm working via a USB cable, but you can also work with the tablet application or just in standalone mode. All three options are available. I also showed you the apps, the scope and run comparison applications are very helpful. And definitely same in an example I showed you just now, it can be valuable to use both. So both the application and the test lab solution to not only measure, but also analyze your data. But of course, if you prefer to work with in-house procedures, maybe competitors, this SCADAS XS is a very open system. When you buy it, you do get a USB stick with a small application to export the data into the many formats that we discussed. And finally, I must say coffee at 7 p.m. is not a good idea, but you know, you do what you have to do. I did wanted to show you how you can use a SCADAS application on a quite a loud device, I would say, and how you can very quickly and efficiently measure sound and vibration and do some analysis, and also the video part. I think that's something that can really help with the solution. Now I measured the video with a tablet application, and that was synchronized and annotated with the run. But you also could do that with your phone, for an example, and import a video from your phone as well. But then, of course, synchronization is something that has to be done manually. Okay, I think it's time for questions. Charles, I don't know if you have an overview of some questions that have popped up.
There are a couple questions that did pop up. The first one, can you export data from the Scope app without bringing it into Test Lab?
Yes. Not all of it, I would say, but here and there you will have the option to export single channels or some of the analysis as an Excel format or as a WAV file if you want to have the audio experience. But for a full experience, meaning that all the channels at the sampling frequencies that we measured, I would still go for this free export tool.
Can I use the ICP and DC accelerometers? Is another question here.
Yeah, there's no problem there, no limitation. Probably should have mentioned it before, but yes, absolutely.
Okay. And I think we covered this a little bit, but maybe I missed this. What type of analysis can you do in Scope?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, indeed. It really depends on your measurement setup. But we can look at time data, of course, but there is also the FFT analysis, and that's both as average spectra as well as color maps. We can look at some octaves. We can also look at some psychoacoustic metrics, such as articulation index or the loudness calculation, both instantaneous and the total loudness. And if you measure RPM, then you will be able also to look at either a single order or kind of an order map in the application.
Okay, that's quite a lot. Is the connection between the XS and the tablet Wi-Fi or USB?
The connection is Wi-Fi. However, there are means and ways to have the connection fixed by a cable. So you can do that. The reason why we went for Wi-Fi is because, as you saw on my video, the XS was laying on the table and I have all the freedom to walk around with the tablet and measure, which you know, it's quite nice because then you can really walk from sensor to sensor to do the analysis. But it's possible to do do a fixed connection.
Okay. Seeing if any more other questions are going to come in. I think maybe one other question, slightly answered perhaps already, but just so they get clarity. What is the interface to the PC when using it with TestLab?
Oh, so I connected by means of a USB cable. Mm-hmm. There is an alternative. You can do it also through a LAN cable, but it's a special LAN cable that we provide with the SCADAS XS, but it will allow you to also to connect via LAN.
And it's powered through that USB too, right? To the
Yes. USB 3 is, I would say, the best way to go. So, but this indeed allows you to measure in front-end mode and at the same time power the device from the USB, because that's actually how you charge it. So that's a good remark. That's actually a nice point about it.
A question here, can we auto export FFT file when doing large group of testing? Maybe like we're using a recorder?
Well, I would definitely do it in a front-end mode, meaning with a TestLab application. That will be very easy. The auto thing with the tablet and just with the SCADAS XS, that's something we would have to look into. So I have to check. But with the TestLab, if you would measure with TestLab or import in TestLab and then accept the fact that you have to import, then that should be possible.
Okay. And I think that was, thanks for all the questions, guys. Appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. If there are more questions that pop up in your head later on, feel free to contact us. Our mails are on the screen, but better contact Charles because, you know, he's the smarter guy in here.
I don't know. It depends on the time of day too. So if you're going to... You're contacting an SCADAS.
It might be faster, Charles.
If you're going to work, you know, depending what time, if you're working really late, maybe give her a call. Yeah, it'll be 8 a.m. for her. You're working here at midnight trying to get something done. Okay, I think that was the last question. Thank you, Aneska, for joining us this evening for you, this afternoon for most of us.
My pleasure.
Thank you, everyone who attended. And as I said at the beginning, I'll send out a follow-up email, which will have a PDF file of this presentation that Aneska presented, a link to a recording of this webinar, as well as links to upcoming webinars in the month of July. And other than that, look forward to seeing you in another webinar in the future. Have a great day.
Thank you.